Hello everyone, in this video we will see deadlock avoidance. So we have multiple deadlock avoidance algorithm. For single instance, we have single instance of resource type, use resource allocation graph, and if you have multiple instance of resource type, we can go for Banker's algorithm. So resource allocation graph is only for the single instances for all the resources, because it is simple. The problem is simpler, so we can go for simpler solution. If the process is having only one resource and the resource is only one instance, so the resources can be allocated only to one process at a time. So if you have multiple instances in a resources, then there is one more solution called Banker's algorithm. First we will see resource allocation graph scheme. So we have seen in last video resource allocation graph with request edge and assignment edge. Now we have means the resource allocation graph is introduced with one more edge called climb edge. If the process PI needs the resource RJ, then first go for a climb edge. Then the resource is compared with other process, it is requested by any other process or is it assigned with any other process or not. If not, the climb edge is converted to request edge if there is no request for those for the resource RJ. If there is no assignment for the resource RJ, then the request edge is converted to assignment edge. So this is how the resource allocation graph for deadlock avoidance look like. So we have the process P1 and process P2. Process P1 is allocated or responded by the resource R1, and process P1 needs R2 as well for execution. So P2 has sent a response or climb edge to the process R2, and P2 has sent a climb edge to the process R2. So process P1 is not served with the R2 because it is already served with process R1, request R1. So the process P2 is served with the request R2, and the climb edge is converted to response edge here, and the process P2 is allocated with R1. So what is the difference between these two graphs is the process P1 in the first graph utilizing R1 and process P2 is requesting for R1. Process P1 and P2 are climbing for R2. In the second graph, the process P1 is already responded with R1, but process P2 is responded with R2 but requesting for R1. Until P2 completes execution, P1 may not get R2, but P2 needs R1 to complete execution. So that is unsafe state. So if this process need to be executed, then if P2 makes request, if P2 gets a climb edge here, so the operating system decides which process to complete first and allocate same resources to another process. So for multiple instances, as I told, we will be making use of Banker's algorithm. If the resource is having multiple instances, then the process must check prior climb for maximum utilization. So if I have the resource RJ and J number of instances to it, then the process must be prior climb all the maximum use of those instances. So when the process requests a resource, it may have to wait until it is responded. Then the process gets all the resources it is requested for, and after it is got responded, it must return all the resources in finite amount of time. So the time amount for the resource access is fixed. The process cannot hold the resources until it completes the execution, but the time is given by this algorithm. So data structures to utilize Banker's algorithm is, let's consider we have n number of process and m number of resource types. So if it is available, vector length of m means m number of resources. If available, j means m of j is equal to k, then k instances of resources type r of j is available. Maximum number of resources is m into n matrix. Maximum of ij is equal to k in the sense p of I has requested for at most k instances of resources of the type rj. So r is a resource, rj is the instances of resources, and pi is the number of instances. The maximum request it can give is k. Allocation, in the same way we have n and m as a resource and process, means n is a process, m is a resource, and the matrix of resource and process, which is allocation for I and j, is equal to k. If pi is currently allocated with k instances of rj, so maximum is the request made, allocation is the allocated, and n is the need. So for the same matrix, need ij is equal to k, where pj is P of I may be needed with k more instances from the RJ to complete the task. So always need is equal to max minus allocation. It is like P needs 10 resources for allocation with for completion. So maximum is 5 in the computer. So it has allocated 3 for the resource execution. So need is equal to max minus 5. So need is 5, sorry, I consider need for the computer is, so need for the process P1 to complete is 5, maximum is 10, allocated is 4. So need is equal to max minus allocation. Safe state algorithm of banker's algorithm, I mean, to verify the program which is safe or not through banker's algorithm, we call it as safety algorithm. So since banker's algorithm is an avoidance algorithm, so banker's algorithm provides safe state for the process which, or for the execution of process which is having multiple instances of resources. Let's consider work and finish as a vectors of length m and n respectively. Work is equal to available, then finish of I is equal to false for I to n minus 1. Then what you have to do, if work means finish of I is false, then find I such that finish of I is equal to false where need of I is less than or equal to work. If no I exists, go to the step 4. So if the need is lesser than the work, then you can allocate and convert the finish of I to true. If not, work is equal to work plus allocation, finish of I is equal to true, then go back to the step 2 where finish of I is false and you have collected previously allocated resources and joined with the work. So you can compare need with the updated work. So updated work, again, if it is lesser, if it is not lesser, you have to repeat the step 3, or you can go to step 4 and finish the execution. Resource request algorithm for the process P1. This is like checking whether the execution is under safer state or not. This algorithm is for requesting for the resources from the process PI. Request RI is equal to request vector for the PI. RI is the request made from the process PI. I is the number for which, means I may be 0 to n number of value. Request from the process I for the instance j is equal to k, where process PI wants k instances from the resource type j. So if request of I is less than need, then go to step 2 where request of I is less than or equal to available, then you can go for the step 4 and you can give the allocation. Otherwise, if request of I is not lesser than equal to need of I, raise a error condition since the process has exceeding the maximum climb, it has to be done. If the request is less than request I is less not less than or equal to available, then PI must wait until the resource is available. If both the conditions request of I is less than or equal to need and less than or equal to available, then you can pretend the allocated request for the resources PI by modifying the states as follows, where available is equal to available minus request, allocation is equal to allocation plus request, and need is equal to need I minus request. If safe, the resources are allocated to PI. If it is unsafe, then PI must wait until other resources is released by the old process. I hope you understood this topic. Thank you.